These are always terrific. How many of you have been to one of these before? Where do you all know the form? The nice thing for me is having not to do anything at all except turn up today and find that these guys have written 11 brilliant songs during the course of the week with the help of some terrific tutors. We'll have a round of applause before we start. Tom and Roger. iPad, but it's actually working the sound by using that thing. Chris and Emma, who have sorted the whole thing out. Rachel has been a help. Loads of people who have been a help. And Graham, of course, who organises the whole thing. They get a round of applause as well. And it's also a really nice time to see old friends. Quite a lot of students come to these every week, every year. And quite a lot are ex-Orpheus and come back to join us for these things. So all together, big treat. And we are going to begin with the first group song that they wrote together, which I heard for the first time this morning, and it's really good. And it's called I Want to Win. Here it is. Welcome the car. Well done.
I'm independent, I am free, this is my life.
how they did this was split up into three groups. One run by Tom, one run by Ross, one run by Kate. And we're now going to hear the three songs done by Tom's group. The first one is called I Do It All Just For You, and has so many soloists in it, I'm not going to list them all because almost everybody has something to do. Yeah, so this is called I Do It All Just For You. All right, ready please?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Oh.
know you believe in dough, I know you believe in bread. Do you believe in me? I might have to go through that again. It's complicated stuff. This next one is called Love is a Country and features Chris Holland on my organ. Holly Shabalda. Songs which didn't exist 5 days ago. Such good songs, aren't they, already? And really easy and catchy. And the danger is that they disappear into Orpheus' archives and never get seen again. So we remember them, one or two of you who are videoing, if you're videoing the whole thing, can you send us the file? I think it's quite complicated, that, but it's possible, isn't it? It's a big file, I think you have to send it to WeTransfer or something and then we get it from there, something like that. But it's really good because actually you are taking the best possible record of what's been done this week by video. So it's one of these few times at the concert where you say it's compulsory to take pictures and use recording equipment and not illegal at all. Right, Ross's group, you're ready to go?
Yeah.
I think that was an accordion. Good mind. I knew what you were all about. Russ's group, again, have produced three songs. This is Russ's group over here. And the first one is called The Sea Is Our Home. And apart from the vocal accordion part, features M on first verse and Chris West on second verse. And probably one or two others as well. Good. Off you go, Russ. The Sea Is Our Home.
One, two, three, four.
Oh,
Everything Orpheus does, everything Treloar does, is about moving on. About not being at Treloar anymore, not being at Orpheus anymore, but going out and living as independently as possible. And this next song is called I'm Moving On. It has an extremely complicated backing, invented by Russ.
Invented by them
and organised by Russ. I'm Moving On.
The main glory of my life.
Thank you.
me and Matthew are still going. Cheers.
And if you're moving on, eventually you arrive. So this next song is called We Have Arrived.
We have arrived.
We have arrived.
Different drum.
dancing. And anybody else? I beg your pardon, I'm from Laurie.
Laurie.
Round of applause for all our soloists.
Tom, our special guest star.
And I think you all have bits to do in his next one, haven't you?
Yes.
As does Katie over here. And the next one's called Breaking the Rules Can Be Fun. It's true. Only purpose of rules.
Yes. Yeah.
Said, did I have a story about the word goodbye? No, I don't. But this one is roughly about the word hello. Little old lady, 70, for her 70th birthday in America, her friends all said, right, we are going to pay for you to go to New York for the first time in your life. And they paid for her to go and stay at the Plaza Hotel. And she was naturally, having never been to New York, she was very nervous about this. But she booked into the Plaza Hotel, went up to her room, and she thought, no, I must be brave. I must go out for the evening. And so she got into the lift, yeah. And as the doors opened on the next floor down, a huge Hell's Angel with an Alsatian got into the lift as well. And she thought, this doesn't look good. And suddenly the Hell's Angel said, all right, lady, get down on the floor or you're going to get hurt. So immediately, the little old lady collapsed on the floor and lay there, terrified as to what was going to happen. They got to the ground floor and the Hell's Angel got out with the Alsatian, and the old lady thought, that's enough for me. I'm going straight back up to my room. I'm not going out again. And she did. The next morning, she came down to the desk to check out. And the manager of the hotel said, it's all right, your bill has been paid. And she said, why? How? He said, Lionel Richie has paid your bill. And she said, why? What? She said, well, I gather last night in the lift, you came across Lionel Richie's road manager and his Alsatian, who is called Lady. And so when the guy said, lady, get down on the floor or you're going to get hurt, not only the old lady, but the Alsatian also got down on the floor, and that's what happened to her. And so she went back home, having had this wonderful experience in New York. Are we ready now?
Yes!
Good. It filled in time, anyway. This is a song called Goodbye, featuring Katie on this magnificent machine. Doesn't have a name, does it? It makes a wonderful sound.
I think it's a piano.
The last song, written by the whole group, is called See Me. As far as I remember, the chorus goes, see me, look at me, see me for who I am, see me, look at me, accept me for who I am. let them do the chorus a couple of times, but when we come to the end, we will all stand up, join in, so we know it's the end. Right. Ready for this?
Yes.
Yes.
Well done.
Folks, it's always good to have a reunion time, and this has become a reunion time. This is the fourth Breaking Boundaries week we've had here at Treloar in the summer. And do we want to make a fifth?
Yeah!
I'd like to just say a few thanks. I'd like to say thanks to Treloar for hosting us.
Good on Treloar.
I'd like to say thank you to, particularly to four sets of staff from Treloar who have supported the Treloar students. So a round of applause for the Treloar. Staff at Orpheus, they give up their week. They get paid for it, but they give up their week because they like to be part of this. So thank you to the staff at Orpheus. Particular thanks to Emma Taylor, who organises the week. Three very inspiring tutors here, some of whom have worked with us several times, many times before, and one who's worked for us for the first time, and that's Russ. So thank you, Russ, thank you, Kate, and thank you, Tom. People in the audience, because without them we wouldn't be here. So let's thank the audience. On behalf of Orpheus, thank you so much for hosting us, and Joe's going to say a few words from the point of view of Treloar.
Good afternoon, everybody. Many of you don't know who I am. There are certain young ladies and gentlemen in the congregation behind me here that do know who I am. I'm the head of Treloar School and College. This is actually the first time that I've actually not been on holiday when you've actually held this event. And I actually think I've had limited use this week, but it's been kind of nice to actually be sitting in my office, actually hearing all the practicing and all the performance. And then today, I wasn't in work yesterday. I was up in London for boring meetings. But to have actually come in and heard this today has been such a pleasure. So thank you, really, to all the staff, to the parents and others that have actually joined us here. And next year, I think actually, Graham, you must make sure that they actually make sure I'm actually in the building next time. You have to make sure I'm in, because I can't miss it next time.
That's okay, John. She's not going to have a holiday. But thank you so much. I know that the traffic is pretty horrendous out there. So we are going to enable our students to take their time to go back to their various rooms, get their bags, and to meet you at the back entrance. For those of you who are taking these young people for a deserved break. Because they deserve it. Don't you deserve it?
Yeah!